In 1976, Redrum, such a gallant runner-up to Les Gargots, again ran second, this time to Rag Trade, and this time ridden by Tommy Stack. So Rummy went into the 1977 National, boasting the remarkable record of 2 wins and 2 seconds from 4 runs. And he became the flagship horse for an event being professionally marketed for the first time. With Tommy Stack again in the saddle, and again carrying top weight, 12-year-old Redrum started at 9-1, with only Andy Pandy on 15-2 preferred in the betting. 42 runners faced the starter for what was to prove the most historic Grand National of the television era.
Will the policeman get out the road, please?
The starter calling for the course to be cleared.
Are they all right?
The contestants, he asked them if they're all right.
Come on.
And this looks like it, they're off. And Spit and Image on the far side is the first to show of that group, and Boomdocker on the near side with Andy Pandy, and Nerio right up with him, and San Willen and Brown Admiral. And over on the far side, Spit and Image, with going up with him, Collingwood on the near side, it's Boomdocker. And as they cross the Melling Road, and we go over to join John Hammer, it's Boomdocker from Sebastian, Brown Admiral, San Willen, and Andy Pandy, and what a buck. And over to you, John.
And Sebastian, just about the leader at the first on the inside from Duffelcoat on the outside, and Duffelcoat has gone. He's the first one to go. It looked as if Spitting Image went as well. Willie Watt has gone. And as they go to the second fence, it's Sebastian in the lead from Prince Rock, then Brown Admiral, then Forest King, then comes Andy Pandy. No fallers at the second fence, and at the third, the big ditch, at Sebastian in the lead from Prince Rock, and Brown Admiral and Forest King have made a mistake. The fall there, Davy Laird has gone, and Innie Caro has gone, Verreta has gone, and also Royal Thrust, and over to Julian Wilson.
And over that one, Sebastian led towards the centre, towards the far side is Prince Rock, towards the stand side is Boomdocker with Stan Willen, Brown Admiral just behind the leaders, then comes Hidden Value. And tracking the leaders on the far side is Sage Merlins. They jumped the one before Beecher. Sebastian over from over in second, Boomdocker. Then came Hidden Value in the centre. Prince Rock towards the far side. And also behind that on the far side is Sage Merlin. Then comes Brown Admiral as they race down towards Beecher's, with Sebastian leading from Boomdocker, Prince Rock, Hidden Value, and Brown Admiral over Beecher's. Sebastian over. And Sebastian's gone to Beecher's. Sebastian's a faller. Another faller, Songwriter, is brought down at the back of the field. And Winter Rain is also a faller at Beecher's. And Castle Runner is a faller at Beecher's. And Lord of the Hill also. And Charlotte Brew is just over. She's over last of all, and she's been badly impeded. But over the next one, and racing down towards the canal turn, is now Boomdocker in the lead from Brown Admiral second, Hidden Value is third, then comes Prince Rock and Forest King on the inside of Sage Merlin, then comes San Willen and Andy Pandy as they jump the canal turn, and over it, it was Boomdocker from Brown Admiral, Hidden Value, a bad mistake there by Forest King, in fourth place is Prince Rock, fifth is Forest King, sixth is Sage Merlin, then comes San Willen behind that, and Andy Pandy and Roman Barr, and then comes Redrum as they jump that one, and still out front is Boomdocker. Boomdocker by 10 lengths from Brown Admiral second, Hidden Value third. In fourth on the outside is Prince Rock with Sage Merlin. Then comes Forest King as they jump the next, and we rejoin John Hammer.
And Pengrail was a faller at the first, and so was Warbonnet, but it's Boomdocker out clear of Prince Rock. Then Sage Merlin is in third place. Over this next fence, Boomdocker over in the lead, not so far in front now, of Sage Merlin. Then comes Prince Rock, then Brown Admiral and Hidden Value. And then comes Redrum, who's going well. And as they go to what will be the third last on the next circuit, it's Boomdocker out clear. Sage Merlin is second, Prince Rock third. And Prince Rock went there. And that leaves Hidden Value in third place. Then comes Andy Pandy and Redrum and Brown Admiral. Then comes Roman Barr and Forest King. And as they head towards the 13th fence, it's Boomdocker out clear of Sage Merlin, Hidden Value, Andy Pandy and Redrum. And Charlotte Bruce still going as we join Peter O'Sullivan.
And Boomdocker a long way clear. Sage Merlin heading the remainder ahead of Hidden Value. Then comes Andy Pandy, then Redrum. Just in behind them come Brown Admiral going strongly, and Roman Barr and Forest King. But as they come down now towards the 13th, it's Boomdocker a long way clear of Sage Merlin, who's going to jump it second. Jumping it third is Hidden Value. Redrum and Andy Pandy next, followed by Roman Barr and Brown Admiral. Then comes Sir Garnet, going well. As they come down to the next, Boomdocker well clear of Sage Merlin. And then closely grouped are Redrum, Happy Ranger, Andy Pandy, Hidden Value, Brown Admiral, Waterbuck, Sir Garnet. Behind Sir Garnet is Nerio, coming to the chair now, Boomdocker. Boomdocker a long way clear at the chair. And he's over the 15th, clear. Sage Merlin comes in to jump it second. And he's down. Sage Merlin a faller there. Hidden Value jumps it next from Waterbuck. Andy Pandy behind them, Brown Admiral. Then comes Redrum and Roman Barr and then Sir Garnet and Boomdocker clear over the water. And it's Andy Pandy who leads the next group over the water, followed by Hidden Value and Waterbuck and Brown Admiral, then Roman Barr, and then comes Redrum, then Sir Garnet on the inside, then Sandwithin and Forest King and Nerio and Happy Ranger, then the Pilgarlic, then comes Churchtown Boy. On the inside of Churchtown Boy is Zeta Sun, and behind them come Eye Catcher, then Collingwood, then Carroll Street, and the Songwriter. A long way back behind the Songwriter is Gay Vulgan, then Foresail. Behind Foresail is Charlotte Brew, just taken the water, getting a cheer from the crowd as going down out into the country. Boomdocker is a long way clear of Andy Pandy and Waterbuck, and Barony Fort still continuing, and over to John Hanmer.
Docker a fuse when well clear at the 17th, and this leaves Andy Pandy in front, all the leaders over that safely. It's Andy Pandy out clear himself now of Hidden Value, then Waterbuck on the inside. Then comes Redrum, and they're over the 18th. And all the leaders once again jumping it safely, though a mistake by Collingwood, and it's Andy Pandy coming to the ditch in the lead from Waterbuck, Hidden Value, Redrum, then Roman Barr, Brown Admiral and Nerio. Then comes Sir Garnet and Forest King. And going to the 20th fence, it's Andy Pandy clear of Waterbuck, then Nerio, and then comes Roman Barr, Hidden Value, Redrum and Brown Admiral, and over to Julian Wilson.
Yes, and Andy Pandy is well clear from Waterbuck in second place. Towards the outside is Redrum, who's going really well as they come down to the one before Beaches, and Andy Pandy is 10 lengths clear over it. Andy Pandy from Waterbuck over in second, Nerio's over in third, then Redrum towards the outside. Behind those are Happy Ranger, then Brown Admiral, Churchtown Boy rather, behind that. Just behind that is Sir Garnet, towards the inside is Brown Admiral, and Hidden Value as the leader comes to Beecher's Book for the second time, and Andy Pandy's down, Andy Pandy down at Beecher's, Nerio is also down at Beecher's, and Brown Admiral's gone at Beecher's as well, but the rest of the field are over, and coming to the 23rd fence, it's now Redrum disputing it with Waterbuck. Just behind these is Churchtown Boy, then Happy Ranger and Sir Garnet, and over that one, it's Redrum who leads. Redrum is the leader as they race down towards the canal turn. Redrum from Churchtown Boy and Waterbuck, then Happy Ranger, and behind that is the Pilgarlic and Sir Garnet as Redrum jumps the canal turn in front. Redrum by two or three lengths from Churchtown Boy, and second in third is Waterbuck in fourth, and Sir Garnet's a faller there. In fourth is Happy Ranger, in fifth is the Pilgarlic, sixth is Eye Catcher, seventh is Hidden Value, eighth is Forest Rock, ninth is Cedar Sun, tenth is Eye Catcher, as they come to the next, and we rejoin John Hanmer.
And it's Redrum in a clear lead from Churchtown Boy in second place. Redrum over there, he pecks slightly on landing. Churchtown Boy second, Waterbuck is third, the Pilgarlic is fourth. Then comes Happy Ranger. And this is the last ditch, the fourth from home. And Redrum's in the lead. A lot of loose horses after him. Churchtown Boy's over second. The Pilgarlic is third. Then comes Eye Catcher. Then Waterbuck and Happy Ranger. Then Forest King. And Carroll Street is next. And at the third last, it's Redrum over in the lead, chased by Churchtown Boy. The Pilgarlic is third. Eye Catcher fourth. Waterbuck is fifth. Happy Ranger is sixth. Then Forest King seventh. Carroll Street 8th, and we've got to look a long way back for anything else, but Redrum the leader across the Melling Road, Churchtown Boy closing, the Pilgarlic in 3rd place, Eye Catcher 4th, and over to you, Peter.
And it's Redrum with two loose horses around him now, just two fences left to jump between he and Grand National History, but close in behind him is Churchtown Boy. The Pilgarlic is about 6 lengths away, then comes the mare Eye Catcher, and then Waterbuck, and behind them Happy Ranger, then Forest King and Carroll Street. They're virtually the only ones left in the 1977 Grand National, and Churchtown Boy is still making relentless progress. Martin Blackshaw coming there very squeakily on Churchtown Boy, but Redrum is still holding the lead now as they jump the second last. He's over the second last in the lead. Churchtown Boy didn't jump it too well. And it's Redrum and Tommy Stack now from Churchtown Boy, the Pilgarlic and Eyecatcher, as they come to the last fence in the National. And Redrum with a tremendous chance of winning his third National. He jumps it clear of Churchtown Boy. He's getting the most tremendous cheer from the crowd. They're winning him home now. The 12-year-old Redrum being preceded only by loose horses, being chased by Churchtown Boy. Eyecatcher has moved into third of the Pilgarlic fourth. They're coming to the elbow. There's a furlong now between Redrum and his third Grand National triumph. And he's coming up to the line to win it like a fresh horse in great style. His hat's off and a tremendous reception. You've never heard one like it at Liverpool. Redrum wins the National. Coming up towards the line, a tired now but game, Churchtown Boy holds Eyecatcher. Churchtown Boy is second, Eyecatcher is third. Fourth is the Pilgarlic and fifth Forest King. Sixth is Waterbuck and seventh is Happy Ranger. Eighth is Carroll Street and ninth will be Collingwood.
Redrum remains the only horse ever to win three Grand Nationals, and his remarkable record in the world's greatest steeplechase, 3 wins and 2 seconds in 5 attempts,